So I started Wayne, straight off from university, joined a company called Accenture, which is a management consulting firm, in 2002, and worked on Wayne as a part-time hobby for about 2 or 3 years. And then in 2005, we took the jump, went full-time on it. We had about 1 million users at the time. And we resigned from Accenture in 2006 and grew a team from 3 to 45. And the site has grown ever since, from literally 45,000 users in March 2005 to over 9.5 million users, and we should be on track to reach 10 million by the end of the year. We managed to get 45,000 users as a result of some campaigns on Google, on AdWords, and that was sufficient enough for us to get the traction and get enough people to refer their friends, because there was enough data on the site. And I think the invite model is one of the things that a lot of Web 2.0 companies are relying on.
But Wayne, surely that's just basically just for backpackers going around the world, isn't it?
Well, that's perhaps one of the biggest misconceptions. Wayne actually has a broad spectrum of users. We over the age of 18. Over 50% of our users are actually over the age of 35, and the most active 7% of our communities are actually over the age of 55. And we have a very well-balanced spectrum, about 25% of our users between the age of 18 and 25, and 24% between the age of 25 to 35. So it's actually really well-balanced. So we've started literally with a £10,000 seed capital, and we introduced a subscription business model very early on, back in 2004. Where you had to pay about £7.50 for a month, or up to £25 for 12 months to get the level of interaction. However, last May of this year, we've changed the model drastically, whereby everything around the interaction is free of charge. Because how do you compete with the likes of Facebook, the likes of MySpace, everything which is open source? So what we've done is we've actually taken an approach whereby we do have the advertising capability. Clearly, being location-based services is great for targeting, knowing that some particular set of people will be traveling at a particular location, a particular time, allow us to charge premium CPM rates. But we have not dismantled the subscription completely. So what we're launching and recalibrating, rather, in the next 2 weeks is an offering whereby not only do you get the online benefits, but also the offline benefits. So the 2-for-1 entries if you travel to New York, the free travel insurance, the global SIM card, you know, all of the things as parts of the membership subscription. It's there to be taken. You don't have to actually subscribe. Everything which is around the interaction is completely free, but there was still an element of subscription which allows us as a company to diversify our revenue sources.